Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory. It's a gorgeous Sunday morning, very sunny, and all of a sudden it turned out to be one of those amazing spring days to go out there and put our spoons to the test, so to speak. So I'm going to walk you through this really fast, and as I've said before, you know, those of you who are starting out and you need to see the, you know, every step, including the spraying and all of that, dig into the archives. We have, you know, we've repeated this process several times now, and there are all these videos that'll show my going through this process and et cetera, et cetera. So I'm making these videos to sort of speak further on the process here. These spoons right here, these are straight out of spraying of the nail polish, the way that I had mixed them in the little bottles. Okay, and so you know, a good shake gets everything going in there. These are paints, I've said this before, with a lot of bling in them. And it's the reason why we're using the Pache Age airbrush, because it can handle heavy volume paints, etc., etc. In particular, paints with bling. Okay, you don't need a one of those automatic stirring cups that come with a little automatic stir in there to keep the flakes afloat and all of that, and you know, in suspension, and the right suspension so that they can be sprayed. excuse me, nail polish is pretty sturdy paint, you know. I mean, this is why our wives and girlfriends you know, the women, our mothers, everybody has been using it, because you apply it and then you put a clear coat and it gets to be pretty strong. I mean, you can chip it, of course, just like if you dropped your model off of the porch railing, you know, you're gonna suffer a little bit, because depending on how that model lands and what it lands on, it's gonna go, things are gonna look pretty bad. But, you know, this is paint that can pretty much take it, and this is paint shot out of the airbrush straight onto the plastic spoon, okay? And we are doing the experiment to see how it takes, you know, the clear, okay? And I'm going to walk you slowly over that in the coming videos. And so this is dry, you know, this is dried overnight. It's a kind of paint, by mixing it with cheap cold, you know, lacquer from Home Depot or Lowe's or what have you. Regardless of the consistency, even though, you know, sometimes thinner won't get you full coverage right away. Like this color took a while to build up, but you're spraying it so thin that it doesn't really, really matter. Okay. So, and we all have our processes and all of that. So, this is mine, and it's worked for me in the past, and it'll hopefully continue to work. So these spoons right here have not been touched with anything, okay? And so, you know, we left them overnight to dry, and we realized that, you know, nothing has happened as I sprayed them over the duplicolor gray primer. So those are fine. This morning, I went out there and I shot this. This is my favorite, what I would call a first stage clear, okay? It's duplicolor, it's still out there. You can pick it up at Advanced Auto Parts, wherever. I love this stuff because it brings its own brilliant glitter effects, right? It brings its own bling, and so when you mix it with other bling, it just blings the heck out of the bling bling, you know what I'm saying? So we love it, and again, it's not cheap, but you know, you can get these. A couple of cans will see you, you know, for a long, long time. Okay, so now we sprayed, just about an hour ago, we sprayed these spoons with a couple of light coats of this stuff, and you begin to see And I hope you can see it. I mean, if I took this out to the sun, it would be crazy. And I have videos where I've taken such parts out in models into the sun, so you can look at those. But take my word for it. These are nice and shiny right now, and it's added a coat of protection. This is not my finishing clear, okay? My finishing clear, I will show it to you probably in the next video when we test the clear on these spoons. So all of these are, you know, sprayed with the duplicolor effects, and so far no reaction. Now this spoon here is very interesting because, and I hope you can see it, it's got ghosted stripes, which I simply did by putting down the tape against the primer, then shooting the base color, which was a very light greenish color that I had mixed. And then I removed the tape after two or three coats of it and added a couple more coats so that the stripes would be ghosted on there. I kind of like that idea, and that's it. And so this spoon also has the clear effects. So there it is. No reaction, nothing happening as of yet. We have one more test to do on all of these, and that is the final clear coat, okay, which is my favorite clear coat, which is a DuPont rattle can clear coat. And and then after that, I'll show you that video, and then after that we're gonna get painting on the bodies and moving forward. So far so good. So we hope you stay tuned in for more Cranky Show coming right up, my friends.